So we're getting into the dead of winter now. It's getting pretty cold, and one thing with that is I want to get set up and fishing as fast as possible and limit my time in the cold weather. Like a lake like this, there's no public access. I gotta kind of beat through the woods a little bit to get here. And so a flip over style fish house with a sled is getting kind of hard to maneuver with one person. Like I said, this lake has no public access, so I can't get a truck or a machine of any kind out here. So I'm basically just left to haul everything on foot. The sleds get kind of hard when the snow gets deep, you know, trying to pull a sled with all your gear in it. And so these hub houses are nice. You can wear them on your back and pull a lighter sled with some of your gear. Another thing that I like to do so I can get fishing quickly is tie on a bait that's a little bit heavier to start out with. You're not messing around with a really slow rate of fall. And you just want to get down there quickly to see if there's any fish. And that'll determine where you want to set up and how you're going to present your bait. So when you've got, like I'm using a 3/8 ounce spoon right now, that's going to get me down quick. I can fish fast. And then I can start making interactions with the fish quicker too. And then they can tell me what they want on a particular day. Like today is a fairly cold day. They might want something that's a little more natural, like a lighter falling spoon. Something that isn't just a slab of metal, something that's got a little tumble and flutter to it. Like a 3/8 ounce tumbler spoon is a fairly large profiled spoon, but it's flat and thin. And so it falls and flutters differently. Another thing with fishing a spoon that has a fast rate of fall is you can get down to the fish quicker. If there's a school, an active school around and they're feeding, you can get right back on them without your spoon traveling outside of the hole or going off at an angle and taking 2 to 3 times longer to get back down to bottom. That's especially true for panfish over basins. When you've got the school finally moving through, you can catch them, drop right back down on them with something like a tungsten jig that has a fast rate of fall. You know, it definitely pays to do your homework too before you head out fishing. On my electronics, I've got GPS mapping, so I can take a look at the lake that I want to go to, if it indeed does have a map, and do a little homework, like I said, see if there's a point, if I want to do some walleye fishing, somewhere I can set up quickly my entrance point onto the lake, or if I'm searching for panfish, looking for those basin areas or where there's going to be a prominent weed line. And I can do that by doing a little bit of homework on my map, which I happen to have right within my electronics. You know, the bottom line is when you've got extreme temperatures like this, keeping things simple is gonna really accelerate your speed of getting set up and getting comfortable and ultimately catching fish.